Hello, my name is Augusta Belknap and I'm a Petrosys Support Geoscientist in the Houston office. The purpose of this video is to show you how to use the Spatial Editor for GNG workflows. The Spatial Editor is a new interface within the mapping module. It has new features that improve on the contour, fault, and polygon editor and replace the CFP toolbar. It also gives users the ability to edit spatial data so that they're no longer limited to editing just Petrosys contour, faults, and polygons. For the next part of this presentation, I'll be going into Petrosys mapping and demonstrating how to use the spatial editor. I'll first start off by showing you how to create contours for better gridding control, then show you how to join contours in order to establish connectivity of isolated highs, and also edit joint contours using smoothing and bending tools. I'll show you how to create polygons based on fault-bounded traps, and finally, how to clip contours to lease outlines. My data consists of 2D seismic lines, faults, lease outlines, and a boundary polygon. Using my 2D seismic interpretation as an input source, I created the following grid. Through my geologic knowledge of the area, I know that there's an anticline in the region and want to add control contour to adjust my grid around the 660 level. To create a new contour file in mapping, I need to use the spatial editor, which can be found under Edit, Spatial Editor. Create a new file. I'm going to title this file Contour, Control Contour 660. To start drawing the contour, I select the pencil tool. And I'm going to add some digitizing options here, such as splining points, which means I'll add a curve. Anytime I draw a jagged line, Petrosys will curve that jagged line. I can also specify the contour level, which is 660, and then start drawing by left-clicking. I'll zoom in here so you can see it a little bit better. Right now I'm just left-clicking along, but if I wanted to draw this interactively, I just hold down my left mouse button and drag my mouse along. I can keep doing this either way. I'm going to close off my contour, and to do this, I'm hovering over my first vertex point and double clicking. This finishes off my contour. Once I'm satisfied by my contour, I select Save to save any of my changes. Now I can go back into surface modeling and modify my initial grid to not only include my 2D seismic lines as an input data source, but also the new 660 control contour I drew. This is the resulting grid, and as you can see, it much better matches my structure, but I noticed some disconnected highs that actually need to be edited. You can do this by selecting, let me zoom into the area I need to edit, such as the 650 contour. I can join these two contours together. I'm going to select my contour, right click, edit. This also brings me into the spatial editor. To select both of these contours, I can either draw a box around the area, and what I'm doing here is just left-clicking my mouse and dragging my mouse along here, so it selects both of these contours. Notice how they've both turned red now. Or I can select one contour and use Control on my mouse, on my keyboard, to select both of them. To break these two contours, I use the erasing tool. To change the size of my editing circle, I can either use the scroll bar down here, or if you press Shift on your keyboard and use your scroll on your mouse to increase and decrease, this also changes your editing circle diameter. So I'm going to go ahead and delete both of these to join them. Notice my contour labels actually move when I delete parts of my contours. Right click to edit the erasing mode. and use my drawing tool again, but this time I'm going to be snapping to a vertex point, and what that means, it's going to grab the vertex point of this contour. I'm going to left click to draw, and it's going to match it to my first vertex point of this other contour. I can do the same thing for around here and just click once I'm done and right click to get out of the drawing mode. A few other editing tools that could be used in this situation are the smoothing and bending tools. First, I'll start off by using the smoothing tool to smooth my contour that I just joined. Notice the two smoothing methods. I can either smooth interactively, and what that means is if I select my contour here, again, edit my editing circle, make it a little bit smaller, I can choose to just smooth a certain section of this contour, or by selection, which actually smooths the entire contour at one time. Turn on live preview, bump up the intensity, and you can see the change there. So decrease it again, increase, so it actually smooths out the whole contour. And to apply any changes, select apply. The bending tool works as it did before in the contour fault polygon editor. So if I wanted to bend one section, I could do that. I can also make my editing circle really big if I want to bend a larger section. I can save any changes I've made to my contour file and use this new contour for regrading again with any of my changes that I've made here. I'm also going to introduce faults into my grading process and then do a depth conversion. Displayed is a portion of my depth converted grid, and I've zoomed in to the area where the faults were introduced. Notice how the faults create a potential hydrocarbon trap. I'll use the spatial editor to create a polygon around the trapped area in order to run volumetrics. To do this, I need to bring both my contour and fault layers into the spatial editor. I brought in my faults first, and then I can drag and drop my contours into this data source area. So now both of these layers are in the spatial editor, ready for editing. But I'd like to create a new polygon file, so file create, specify that it will be a Petrosys polygon file. Give it a name. And now I'm ready to start drawing using my drawing tool. I'm going to use a snapping feature, snap to trace of an outline. So what that means is I'm going to trace the outline of my faults and then move on to the contour back to this fault. So this will trace around this whole area. So I'll first start off, and I can zoom in here too. And anytime I hover over an object that will be traced, my cursor turns from a cross to a hand, signifying that it's selecting that contour. So I can just go ahead, move down here, move along to my fault. Back to my 3,340 contour, and then to my upper fault. And double click to end my polygon. Also, I need to name my polygon. And save any of my changes. Next, I would like to clip the contours that lie within a few of my lease sections. And to do that, I need to bring my lease outlines into the editor. First, I need to select all of the contours because that's what I'll be doing the clipping on. So I did that just by dragging that box around and I selected all of my contours. Then I'll use this Clip Shapes Against Arbitrary Polygons tool. Select which shapes I want to clip. I've already selected these four, but let me show you what was done here. So it's just select polygons, select your shape file or other spatial file you would perform the clipping within. I've selected four of my lease sections, so A, B, C, and D, and select OK, and then perform the clipping. So that clips all of the contours within these four lease outlines. And now I can save my clip contours out as something such as a file geodatabase or any of these other output sources. That concludes my demonstration. Jumping back into my PowerPoint, just as a recap of what we just saw, we first saw how to create a controlled contour for better gridding control, join contours to establish connectivity of an isolated high, and use the editing tools such as smoothing and bending, then create a fault-bounded trap polygon to use while running volumetrics, and finally, how to clip the contours to a lease outline and save the clip contours out into a different file format. I would like to thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions for support, please email us at support@petrosys.com.au, or for more information, email at info@petrosys.com.au.